Welcome to a quick video tutorial on using lists in Desmos. Let's start by creating our first list. To do this, we'll enter square brackets and a comma-separated list like 1, 2, 3. So what's the big deal with lists? Sometimes it's better to show than tell. Let's name our list L1, then type y equals x squared plus L1. Notice what happened? One equation turned into three graphs thanks to list L1. And if you adjust list L1, say by adding the number 4, the new results appear instantly on the coordinate plane. So, lists can help you compare different results and graph multiple equations at once. You can create lists in a few other ways. Let's say you want to generate an evenly spaced list between two numbers. We'll use 0 and 8 for this example. Enter a square bracket and then your first number, 0. Then, add an ellipsis, or three dots, followed by your final number, 8. Now you'll have a list of every integer from 0 to 8. We'll call this list L2. We can also change the increment between the elements in the list. Let's say you want to generate a list that starts at 10 and counts by 5s up to 95. Open the square brackets and start at 10. Add a comma and then enter 15 to tell the calculator we want to count by 5s. Finally, we'll enter an ellipsis and our last number, 95. We'll call this list L3. We already saw how lists can work in an equation back with list L1, but we can use lists in other ways too. Let's use list L2 to create ordered pairs. If you add the point L2, comma sine of L2 to an expression line, the calculator will generate 9 ordered pairs based on the values in list L2. The first point is calculated using the first element of L2, which is 0. This is plotted at the point 0, comma sine of 0, and so on for each element of L2. You can even define lists in line. For example, if you type a point with an x value of 0 and a y value list of 1, 2, 3, 4, the calculator plots 4 points, all with an x value of 0 and y values of 1, 2, 3, and 4. We can also use lists for a variety of statistical operations. For example, if you enter total of L3, the calculator will add up all the values in list L3 and tell you the sum. You can also try other functions on lists, such as mean or median. These examples are just an introduction to using lists. You can learn more in the Desmos Help Center. We can't wait to see how you'll use lists.